Ciao friends! Let's see how to analyze ticket sales performance data of a big venue by using Power BI and Synoptic Panel. In this report, we see a big venue, the Sphere in Las Vegas, where we are displaying revenues and occupation, at the moment the revenues, for the ticket sales. Of course, the data is fictitious, this is not real data, but the venue actually exists. You see that we are grouping all the seats in sectors and then in categories. And the categories that you see on the side, on the right side of the report, are also visible on the left side of the report in the classic visualization with a table. Of course, the advantage of having a graphical visualization is that we can see the location of the data. And the information, for example, about the best sector that we can highlight by clicking this row is available just as a number if we take a look at the table here. But when we see where this section is located, we can also see that the fact that the revenue is smaller, you see that the number, the absolute number is 22 million as an aggregate, is caused because we have a relatively small area for the best seats. Of course, the price is almost double, as you can see here. But once we see the physical location of the seats, we can understand better what is going on. For example, if I also drill down in the chart, I can see the information by sector. So we see that the revenues is much higher in a few sectors. And if I choose to filter only the events that are conferences or concert, I can also see differences in the revenues and in the occupation percentage. We can see the occupation percentage by clicking on this other button. We could go down at the seat level. And so we see that the seats, and in this case, the seats occupation is much higher for conferences compared to concert. Why? Because people probably tend to stay more in the center. They want to see the show, they want to see the action. And in the conference, probably they just want to listen to the content. And so the position is less important and probably they want to save money. Remember, this is fictitious data, but we try to create reasonable data to show the differences from a graphical perspective. The purple ones are seats that have not been sold. This could be a problem in the data, for example, or it could be because those seats are under maintenance or there is some physical element that stops the ability to see what is going on, and so those tickets probably are not sold at all. So I think that we don't have to explain the advantage of looking at the data from a graphical perspective, but what is going on, how this is possible. First of all, the visual is not for the sphere. The visual Synoptic Panel is a generic visual that can get any graphical element. Usually we use SVG files, which is a vector format where every element can be displayed in an HTML page, let's say. But this format, which is pretty standard, can describe floor plans, seat maps, or just other kind of design, maps if you want. Probably for the maps there are more specialized visuals, but this is a very generic visual where we can start from a design. We can export this design in this SVG format, which is pretty common, and then we have to map this SVG format into something that connects to our data. Because what we have in the model, and let's take a look at the Power BI desktop file that we used to create this report, what we have is actual data in tables, in measures. So we have the measures here, occupation and revenues that we have for the tickets, and this information has been used in the report. Now, the map that we have here is not just one. We have several SVG files that have been combined into a single visualization. You can see here the detail of all the maps that have been used at different levels of details, different levels for each sector, so that we can have multiple navigation. Of course, the navigation can be organized in a hierarchical way. For example, in this visual, we have three different levels. So let's see if I can show the configuration here. So we have category, sector, and seat. And these three levels have been mapped into the corresponding data points in the corresponding areas of the SVG file. So if we go back to the configuration in the edit mode, we can see an example. For example, in this map, if we go to edit, this is a very high level map, one of the many that we have. And each of these areas is an element that has been mapped into a particular information, a particular value for a column of the model. In this example, economy is a group of four different elements, graphical elements, and this economy is the same name, the name of the object, the group object we have in the SVG file is the same name of the information we have in the column values. But in case it was different, we could have used the specific name. So for example, we could have mapped our name, our FGH something, into, for example, economy. Now in this case, because we don't have to do this translation because the names are the same, we're using autobind, which is what we suggest to do when you have, for example, the seats. When you look at the detail of the seat, and we can see this in this visualization here, at the seat level, the seat is just this number, this string, and you don't want to do this manually for thousands of seats, like the number of seats we have in a venue like this. And so usually we suggested to prepare the SVG file using some scripting, some tool, so that you already have the right names. This is the more efficient way to manage large maps. But in case you have a small number of objects and you want to just map them manually, you already have a tool inside Synoptic Panel to do that. You will find many information about Synoptic Panel on the website. We have a use case for this example that explains in more detail how it has been built and gives you more information about how to create something similar, for example, for a theater, for a stadium. Just one note, if you have a stadium with 60,000 seats, probably you want to skip the global visualization because having tens of thousands of data points in Power BI could be slow, not because of Synoptic Panel, but because of the infrastructure of Power BI. So we usually suggest to stay in a few thousands for the maximum level of detail. And then, of course, you could have different sectors. And then when you drill down at the sector level, then you show all the thousands of seats that usually is the limit we suggest for the data points in a single element. So if you have a problem like the spheres of Las Vegas, or maybe a smaller or a larger venue, or you know something that could take advantage of this tool because they could display data in a more intuitive way, take a look at Synoptic Panel, try it out, and let us know.